Hey, Kevin here from the YouTube science channel Vsauce2. When European naturalists first encountered the duck-billed platypus, they thought it was a hoax. Some sewn-together mashup. A practical joke. Because at first glance, the duck bill, beaver-like body, the webbed feet, this odd collection of features don't seem to fit. But just because none of it makes sense to us, doesn't mean it doesn't make sense for the platypus. Or its environment. After all, evolution isn't a beauty pageant, it's a freak show. And the only prize is survival. First things first, platypuses don't have nipples. They have mammary glands, but no quote-unquote teeth. Instead, they sweat milk from their stomachs. Well, not their stomachs, they don't have those. Their esophagus just drops straight down into their intestines. So I guess they sweat milk from their tummy? Which, mind you, doesn't have a belly button. Because they lay eggs. One of only two mammals to do so. So they don't need them. But honestly, who needs nipples when you have a venomous spur on your heel strong enough to kill an adult dog? Or incapacitate a grown human? And who needs good eyesight when you can hunt using electrical currents with your duck face? Underwater. What is this thing? What's going on here? A platypus is many things. Boring, it is not. Although they do sleep 14 hours a day. So there's that. Being a platypus is sweet. Wish I was a platypus. The platypus is such a magnificent weirdo that it's easy to miss the very specific set of circumstances that have allowed this tiny tweener to succeed. Geologically speaking, Australia is a unique place. After the continent split, it was the only major landmass to never experience an ice age. The continent itself has just been slowly drifting into warm tropical water. In this way, it's an incredibly calm ecosystem. An ecosystem where a half-blind hybrid otter duck could thrive. And it's not just a platypus. 86% of plants, 84% of mammals, and 45% of birds found in Australia are not seen anywhere else. Monotremes, marsupials. It's home to some of the world's rarest species, an island of misfit toys. It's that old expression, a fish doesn't stink underwater. Who said that? Basically, nothing's weird when everything is. And in that small and strange corner of the world, the duck-billed platypus has found its niche, its home, its people. So who's weird now? Thanks for stopping by, and I'm out. Want more on the platypus? You gotta click here to explore Museum Victoria's online exhibit that has all sorts of amazing content on this odd little guy. Be sure to subscribe to the Google Arts and Culture channel by clicking right here. Thanks.